Hello everybody, I'm going to present you today how to make a bench power supply out of this DVD player, as you can see it here. Alright, so let's get started. For this project, we're going to need an old DVD player, preferably functional, some kind of container or plastic thingy to put the power supply in, or lab bench power supply. For this project, I'm going to use this old nail polisher bottle. It's alright, in funny shape, and this old DVD. We're going to open it up, this stuff. You're going to use the power supply of it, and as well these connectors here. Okay. Alright friends, we are back now. We have the main board, which is this one over here. This is the power supply of that DVD that I showed you earlier. It's got here a switch, which is convenient. This is the input side that goes to the mains, and here normally it's got some output. As we can see here, we got a ground symbol here, so I'm guessing this one is gonna have two outputs, probably 5 volts and 12-15 or so. Yeah. Let's put it in the mains and test it out to see what voltage is going to give us our future power supply homemade. Alright, so we have the board, we have this connector that we're going to plug into the main, so be very careful when you're going to use them. The mains voltage, we're going to connect it, we're going to flip it over, and we're going to start from here and measure these outputs. Always connect your finger to the cable before you're gonna plug it to the mains. Okay, we have our power supply and we're gonna connect it to the mains. Alright, so no sparks or nothing. Alright, so now be very careful when you're gonna use this board. Just flip it over. We got a switch here. And now with our voltmeter, I'm gonna go into the 20 volts range. We're gonna power it up. Oh, okay, so no sparks. It's okay, it's working. Now let's see. So I said this one is the minus. All right, so we got a 4.5 volts and 12. So we have figured out the pins. Is this one here, which is 16, come on, 16.3, and this one, is 4.6. Alright, so we're gonna have two outputs, 16 volts and 4.55 volts. Alright, so let's proceed. Alright, so we have our board, we have this plastic container, we're gonna measure the bottle like so, we're gonna cut it open, we're gonna insert it inside, and then we're gonna solder the connection to this RCA connection. Alright, stay tuned. We have all the parts necessary, we have the connector, we have the power supply over the DVD, we have the case, and we're gonna use this one from another DVD to transfer the templates on this side. Basically, we're gonna need the switch, which we're gonna put it somewhere here. I'm gonna mark it and transfer it to our thing like so. So we have the switch, and we're gonna put those three connectors. Let's see, we're gonna put like so, to be in line with the switch. This is just for looking nice. So one, 3.
Alright friends, we have managed to have all the parts, the container, the power supply, the connectors and the switch on and off. We're gonna introduce all this stuff in this box here. Let's see if we're gonna manage to hold on to the wires. I'm gonna introduce this one in the box. Ta-da! Homemade one. So let's bring in a plier. Alright friends, we're gonna put these cables through this hole in the back. This is gonna be the main power. Come on. Very easy. Very careful as well. Look how nice it's sliding in. Almost perfect. Something is happening. The wire is kind of big. Have to remove some stuff. Alright friends, one more try. I have to make some minor adjustments to the hole in the back here. Let's try and slide it all the way. That's it. Let's try one more try. Yeah. That's more likely. Alright folks, after a long process we have managed to assemble the power supply. We have here the switch, we have here the input from the mains, and the board is inside here. Now we're gonna just put in the switch. We're gonna tilt it into position. Let's see, with one up or no? Nah, like this. It's better like so. I'm gonna put it, slide it in. That's it. Slides in perfectly. Adjust it. Something. Yeah, that's it. And now I have to move a little bit the board to be able to slide in the connectors. I said this one is 12 volts, so I have to tilt this one. We have to put something in between these wires and the board. Be back soon. That's it folks, we managed to assemble the power supply. We just gonna need to put a screw here to hold on the connectors there. Oh, this is it friends, our finished product, our lab bench power supply, homemade. We got two outputs for 15 kind and 5 volts, one switch, and this is the thing. What do you think? Huh? Looks kind of shitty, but it's gonna do the job, so it was free, so you cannot complain about it. To connect to those thingies, we're gonna use this one as well as from the DVD player as well. So let's connect it and then a multimeter test. Alright friends, we have connected our power supply to the mains. We have our switch. Right, we're gonna connect the probe to the 15 volts output. We're gonna turn it on and we will see if we're gonna get 15 volts. Here we go. 14.6. Yeah, so it's working. Let's connect it now to the second output. Just this. Again, power on. Power. Come on. Yeah, 4.2. That was all for us today, friends. Thanks all for watching. See you next time. In the meanwhile, thumbs up, subscribe, and the full project is gonna be on the description below onto instructables.com. Thanks all for watching. See you next time. Bye bye. Yeah. Power bank, babe.